say. This is what the church say, it's what the church want say. This is what the church won't say.
So I want to go back to my man T real quick. What made you stop cheating on your wife? Well, have you stopped cheating on your wife?
That's probably a better question.
That's a great
right?
question. Yes, I have.
Okay.
Amen. Okay. And what stopped me? It was the love of your father. It was the love of God. It was when I saw myself for who I was in my brokenness with God. And that where I really, so this is the process. So sometimes, and this often happens, right? That people get married and they really broken, two broken people trying to make each other whole. It never works. 50-50 doesn't make 100. You need to be 100 in God, and your spouse need to be 100 in God, and you compliment. So because we did it backwards, and my wife and I, we have a marriage ministry, and so we talk about this often. And this was the process for me, is that I had to now become single again in God. Mm-hmm. Though I'm married, the process of what Jose was saying, I still had to do that. I couldn't skip it. So though I was married, so I still have my marriage obligations that I still have to adhere to, but the process of growing in God and finding myself rooted in Him, and for Him to be able to show me my character flaws, the practical things that I need to fix and to get right, and that where I had to now rely on Him, that no, your identity is not in how you look, it's who you are in me. You know, and so it's not hinged on what your wife say or don't say. Though every man will love a compliment, but that is not what makes Terrence. And I had to grow in that and to rest in that. And so now I'm being built up. And no, I'm not who my father was. You know, because that's another thing too. So generational curses, I had to get past that. Yes. Is that the reality of the new creature that I am in Him. And so I had to just sit there and rest there and not go in circles. And so it was really until I had focused on that. And then I think the last thing that really propelled me is when the Lord dealt with me on lasciviousness. And the thought of lasciviousness. And lasciviousness, it's not, it is sexual, where there, it could be sexual thoughts in a sense of that, where it's unguarded, that you do not guard your mind from various thoughts, but it can be on all type of levels, right? So say for instance, if you're driving down the street, somebody cuts you off, you cuss them out and then you keep going. Well, you didn't think twice about it. It was an unguarded thought. You just roll with it. But there needs to be guardrails, long story short. So the Lord was showing me back in when I was a child how, oh, when you was in high school, you was the biggest flirt. Because that was an area that type of behavior was just doorways for lust to come in. Mm-hmm. And so the Lord said, no, you need to guard your heart and how you move. And I need you to walk in my character. Really in my image and in my likeness, you know, and something that you and I discussed about burning the boat,
yes.
Which I'll let you allude to that, you know.
So something, when y'all breaking up with somebody, right, or you got a habit that's been really destroying your life, I give the story of this general, right? So this general was about to go wage war in a whole other nation. So his whole army got on the lake, or got on the sea, and they rolled over to this other nation. And he was known for his strategic tactics of in war. He never lost a war. But when they got over there, they saw this army on the hill, and the army was massive. And his soldiers were scared. They were like, I don't know how we're gonna win this battle. So the general has an idea. He said, we can win this battle, but I need y'all to do one thing, is trust me. They're like, okay. He said, burn the boats. And they burned the boats. They like, how are we going to get back home? He said, exactly. This is our home. Either we fight and we win this battle, or we die. And when you really want change, when you really want to cut somebody off, when you really know that this person is attached to you and they causing your soul to decay, you got to burn the boat. This is about your wholeness. Do you know who you are in your heart determines will you fulfill your purpose or not? Yeah. So I want y'all to keep that in mind. You're guarding you. You don't want to be crazy? Mm-hmm. I don't want to be crazy.
So I had to burn the boat. I was burning a lot of boats. So for a season, I stopped wearing cologne. Because that was an easy attraction. I mean, I love colognes. I love great smells, Savage, all of that stuff. But that was an easy attraction for a woman to say, ooh, he smelled good. I'm not saying I'm the ugliest guy in the world, but I know I'm not the finest either. But yet, it's just little things. You know, if it's a weight, that any weight that's so easily beset, me cut it off. It's not worth it. Because I'm working towards something. So, no, I don't need no cologne at work. I just wear it when I'm with my wife. Because right now, I can't deal with the extra attention.
Right.
That comes my way just off of that. So I had to burn that boat.
That's good.
Amen.
I want to say that to y'all ladies. What he said was, there's something so small as cologne.
Yeah.
But that's how hungry he was for change. And I think sometimes we think we can give God 25% and then it don't work, and then we say, God don't work, the word don't work. It's 100%. You give 100%, you guaranteeing change. You do not. How many of y'all work out once a week? How much results you seen, brother? Right. Very little. Because you're not hungry enough. Right. And that's what we do when we're trying to change from being promiscuous, or we're trying to change the type of men we're dating. It got to be 100%. Yeah. It really is. So for God to fill this up with 100% of him, first got to empty out what's in here.
Yeah.
And that's where you're emptying out these bogus relationships and habits, those sins that easily beset you. So.